We are from Cesar Chavez Public Charter School for Public Policy, Parkside Campus, located in Wall 7. We chose Eric Dawkins' challenge. I challenge you to unleash peace, to counter the culture of violence presented in all communities by working with unlikely allies to identify a police of common hurt and disconnection. Design a project and address it with creativity, humor, and courage.
Our names are Adam, Alexis, Alexis, Daquan, Cabria, Luis, Renee, and Takia. And we are Potato Sap. Or for short, Peaceful Allies for Youth. Our vision statement: we are here to shed light on police brutality and to find if police target a specific age group, race, or gender in order to increase peace between youth and the police. We chose Potato Sap to stand out, be different, and to be creative.
To address the negative perceptions of police by youth and the crippling issue of police brutality, we decided to first uncover the thought of our peers. We administered an initial survey at our school and conducted an experiment at local metro stations to better understand how teens interact with the police. From gathering this information, we hope to gain a better understanding of youth perceptions of police to help improve and create stronger trust between police and the youth.
Next, we analyzed our data, surveys, and videotaping, and discovered that 80% of our scholars do not trust the police. When asked the question, what's the first thing that comes to mind when they hear the word police, all they thought was, what has happened now? We also heard words like snitch, 12, ops, and pigs.
Armed with our data, we sought to connect with police district leaders. We spoke to Captain Andre Wright of the 7th District of Washington Metropolitan Police Department. We learned the police department is aware of the problem and are striving to solve it through partnerships with organizations and program planning.
To share our findings and loop back to our peers, we held an after-school town hall session to share results of the first survey information from our experiment and key things from our interview with Captain Wright. At the end, we asked for teens to complete a survey about their feelings toward the police after learning this new information.
The survey did not surprise the teens. However, the perceptions on the police have changed in a positive way. In fact, 49% of the students said they can now see themselves building a positive relationship with the police. Teens even gave friendly advice to our unlikely allies, such as, show us that you care, and this is all that we ask for. Cue the video, please.
Okay, so overall, we heard from both stakeholders that there needs to be more communication and understanding of their situations. We need to keep the conversation to ensure that other schools investigate their teens' perceptions of the police. We posted our survey tools and agenda with the police for others to use. Thank you for your time. And we welcome your questions.
Congratulations, great job. Do we have questions from the judges?
Great job, you guys. That was an amazing presentation. My question is, how do you all plan on continuing the dialogue throughout the rest of the year? I know that on the one pager that you all submitted, that was great and outlined everything really well. You mentioned a toolkit. Can you describe that a little bit further for us?
Okay, so we plan to share our toolkit with pretty much everyone in the school so they can share it with others. So what we basically plan to do is share with others and just keep the conversation going. We plan to in the future, I plan to create websites for it and also use the social media to promote police brutality.
You talked a lot about looking at your perceptions of the police. What are you doing about the police's perception of you, of teenagers?
Well, in the video, that was a part of what we were trying to do. We tried to get us as young people to realize that some of our actions are perceived differently through their eyes and the way we react to them. So we're going to try to change the way we react to the police so that they don't have a reason to react their way that they do.
Were the police receptive to you guys being advocates for the youth?
Well, the police, when we interviewed the captain, he said that he understand how we view them because some police are, they use very aggressive tactics to get our understanding through because of we already perceive them as somebody that's bad, even though when we need them, we call on them. So he even, gave an example of a kid that got locked up, seven times in, 1 week, but it was for, because his parents abandoned him, he had to take care of his two little sisters, and he was only 12, so they understood him, and they dropped all the charges, and they took account of his predicament.
Did you all engage only with the police in your neighborhood, or was this something that you'd like to take citywide?
It's definitely something we would like to take citywide. We want to make this as broad as possible. We don't even want to just do it citywide. We want to take it countrywide, maybe even worldwide, because there are police because there are police brutality all over the world, and this shouldn't just be for our city. This should be beneficial for everybody.
Thank you.
Really, really good. Really, really good. Really good. Thank you so much, Cesar Chavez, Public Policy School. Thank you very much.